we see here is an exercise called Lock Shields, which is the biggest and most complex international live fire cyber exercise in the world. This year we have 20 blue teams, defending teams, 19 national teams and one NATO team from NATO NSIRC. Altogether more than 800 people participating.
And we have color based roles here. As you can see here in the control room, is each team member carries a certain color t-shirt. That means that white team is the controlling the game, red team is attacking, green team is building up the environment, and the yellow team is providing us situation awareness. The fifth team, the blue team, is located in their own capitals. They are the defending teams. Regarding the general setup of the exercise, and if we are talking about the systems, then we have built up 3,000 virtual machines for this exercise. Altogether, 3,000 is not a lot, but we have to understand the services that we are running on these virtual machines. So we have built up an environment that is close to real life as possible.
One of the specialties of this year's Lock Shields are the special systems. In addition to normal systems, what we are using in office environments, like file servers, web servers, and all that software, we are also running here in the Lock Shields several special systems which are deployed in a normal military airbase. We have a fuel supply system, played out in a PLC, programmable logic controllers. We have an air command and control system, which is implemented here in background. And we also have a Siemens power supply system. It means that it is a power grid control system, which is implemented in the Lock Shields environment.
Our main purpose is to provide entertainment to the blue teams. So we have 20 blue teams to attack. And this means for a red team a lot of workflow, of a lot of objectives to do. So we have 72 objectives per each blue team. And if you multiply that with 20, you get more than 1,400 objectives that we need to achieve.
I've seen yet another increase of complexity for the blue team to be able to defend the network in a proper manner, which is good. I think it reflects very much what we could expect in real life about the range of cyber attacks that they are facing, the kind of stress level that imposed on the team, on the team leader, and the fact that it's not only, of course, it's predominantly a technical exercise, but the fact that there is a media element in it, there is a legal element into it, which totally makes sense in what can happen in reality, makes this exercise very realistic.